Hello, my name is Diana Almanzar, and I'm going to be reciting the K-word. Check physician's orders, check for allergies, assemble my tools, assess the patient, wash my hands, introduce myself, identify the patient, provide for privacy, educate, evaluate, and explain.
Knock on the door. Hello, my name is Diana. I'm going to be a nurse today. Can you tell me your name and date of birth? Okay, I'm just going to verify. All right, so I'm here today because I heard you have some secretions. I'm going to go ahead and be suctioning some of them off from your trach. Is that okay with you? Okay, all right. So I would raise the bed to a comfortable position. And I would... So I would listen to the patient. Make sure that he does have secretions, and then I would turn on suction. Suction is going to be turned on from 60 to 120 on right here. Okay. First, we'll start with the which is check. And I'm going to get my suction ready on the opposite side because that's the side I'll be working on. Okay, and aside from assessing his breath sounds, I'm also going to be putting a pulse off on his finger and checking for his oxygen level. I'm going to go ahead and lay a towel across his chest so that I won't get him dirty when I do suctions. And this is going to be my oxygen to oxygenate my patient as I'm doing the procedure.
I'm going to turn the suction on to 110.
All right. So, I'm going to start with my, I would wash my hands, provide for privacy, get my sterile field ready. Okay, and now we'll get my water ready. Okay, so now I'm ready to get into my sterile field. So I'm going to go ahead and get my gloves on.
So you know where to hook up.
Before I start, I'm going to amputate his arms, seeing how much that I might need to go in, how many times I might need to go in and out. So now I'm going to open my kit.
Okay, sterile gloves are on. And I'm going to go ahead and grab the
outer one inch.
Before I start the procedure, I'm going to go ahead and check my oxygen on the patient. If the oxygen is low, then I'm going to go ahead and oxygenate my patient. Once I oxygenate my patient, I'm going to go ahead and put this together. So now, I'll go ahead and start suctioning. His O2 is good, so I'll start suctioning. I'll let him know, are you ready? Okay. So I'm going to go ahead. Okay, so first, before I go in, I would go ahead and dip it in here, in the solution, before I start my suctioning. So, put it here. I will let him know, make sure he's ready, and then I'll start inserting.
I don't think this is
okay. I meet resistance.
I wanted to stop, and I thought, does she want to do or not? I don't know what trouble this is.
And then I'll go ahead and look at the mucus, assess it, and then go ahead and dip it in here and then. I will listen to the lungs and see if they're clear already. If they are, I will stop. If they're not clear, then I will go ahead and go again, but I'll go ahead and give him some rest and make sure his oxygen goes back up. If not, I would oxygenate him again and do the whole procedure again. So I'm going to go ahead and do it again. Okay, I will stop where he coughs or meet resistance. Start twisting the suction. Okay. He's good now. So, patient is clear now. I will listen, make sure he's clear. Oxygen's good. I'll be done with the procedure. So I'll go ahead and get him cleaned up, lower the bed, give him the Colite, and make sure he's okay.